On the way home, however, the weather changed. Wind and rain buffeted Edward. His sanding gear failed, his wheels slipped, and his fireman rode in front, dropping sand on the rails by hand.
Come on! Come on! Come on! Panted Edward breathlessly. This is dreadful!
But there was worse to come. Before his driver could check them, his wheels slipped fiercely again and again. With a shrieking crack, something broke and battered his frame and splashes up and out of shape. The passengers gathered round while the crew inspected the damage. Repairs took some time. One of your crank pins broke, Edward, said his driver at last. We've taken your side rods off. Now you're a single, like an old-fashioned engine. Can you get these people home? They must start back tonight.
I'll try, sir, promised Edward.
So with the fireman sanding carefully in front, the driver gently opened the regulator.
Come on,
puffed Edward. He moved cautiously forward, ready to take the strain as his tender coupling tightened against the weight of the first coach. The first coach moving helped to start the second helped the third, and so on down the train.
I've done it! I've done it!
Puffed Edward, his wheels spinning with excitement.
Steady, boy, warned his driver, skillfully checking the wheel slip.
Well done, boy. You've got 'em, you've got 'em.
And he listened happily to Edward's steady beat as he forged slowly but surely up the hill. The passengers were thrilled. Most had their heads out of the windows. They waved and shouted, cheering Edward on. Controller paced the platform. Henry with the special train waited anxiously too. They heard a beep beep. Then battered, weary but unbeaten, Edward steamed in. The fat controller stepped angrily forward. He pointed to the clock. The excited passengers swept him aside. They cheered Edward, his driver and fireman to the echo before rushing off to get in Henry's train.